الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق وعز المرسلين أبي القاسم محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
وعلى آل بيته الأطيبين الأطهرين سيما بقية الله في الأرضين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: إني وجدت امرأة تملكهم وأوتيت من كل شيء ولها عرش عظيم. صدق الله العلي العظيم. In life we start with the smallest particle in life we call الذرة, which we call an atom in English. A group of atoms make up a cell, and a group of cells make up a human part: a hand, a heart, liver. And a group of the human parts make up a human. And a group of humans make up a family. A group of family makes up a tribe. A group of tribes make up a clan. Group of clans make up a nation. Group of nations make up a country. Group of countries make up a continent. And groups of continents make up what we have today, what we call the Earth. The group of planets similar to the Earth, we call the solar system. And solar systems make up what we have, what Allah created as the galaxy. If you look at what we began with, which is the actual atom that we started, the smallest particle, by itself, it has a meaning. By itself, it has a function. And as a group, it also has a function. You cannot separate it. It functions as individual and as a group. If we look at the Holy Quran, we find that the Holy Quran starts off with a letter. Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ayn, Sad, Alif, Lam, Mim. A group of letters in the Holy Quran also make up a word. A group of words make up a sentence. A group of sentences make up a topic. Group of topics makes a surah. A groups of surah, we call them juz', and a groups of ajza', we call them the Holy Quran, which is the 30 ajza'. Also, if we look at the Holy Quran, the smallest particle, the smallest atom in the Holy Quran, which is the actual letter, it has a meaning by itself, and it helps the group as well. And you ponder if you ponder close enough on these words, you find out what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to, what point He's giving. In the verse that we started with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in chapter of An-Naml, says on the tongue of the Hudhud. Hudhud is a bird that was amongst the assembly of Nabiullah Sulaiman. Sulaiman alayhi salam had an army assembled, and that army included the animals, included humans, included jinns, it included the wind. And every now and then he would check up his army, his armed personnel. So here he was missing the hudhud, this bird. And Nabi Allah Sulaiman says, مَا لِيَ لَا أَرَى الْهُدْهُدَ أَمْ كَانَ مِنَ الْغَائِبِينَ. I don't see this bird. He's missing. That verse by itself gives us an example of how a righteous king or how a righteous leader has to be, always checking up on his own people. He says, he's missing. I don't know where he is. I can't find him. What shall I do? لَأُعَذِّبَنَّهُ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا. He makes a decision very quick. That's what a king like Sulaiman needs to do. Prophet Sulaiman makes it. He says, لَأُعَذِّبَنَّهُ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا. He says, indirectly, he says, I'm going to start a legislation. And the legislation is, for all of you who are absent from now on, from my kingdom, because no one was absent before. This is the first time someone was absent. لَأُعَذِّبَنَّهُ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا أَوْ لَأَذْبَحَنَّهُ or I may sacrifice him. أو ليأتيني بسلطان مبين. Or he better come with a good excuse. فمكث غير بعيد قال أحط بما لم تحط به وجئتك من سبأ بنبأ يقين. The bird was not far enough and came and says, hey, before you do anything, before you make any decisions, I came to you from a land called Saba in Yemen. حَطُّ بِمَا لَمْ تُحِطْ بِهِ I found some information you had no knowledge of. And here comes what we started with. It says, إِنِّي وَجَدْتُ امْرَأَةً تَمْلِكُهُمْ The bird was surprised to see that the female was in charge of these people. He says, I came across these people in Saba. And he says, I was surprised that a female leads the crowd. Even the animal doesn't like females. He says, I am very surprised. Why? The bird at that time was also racist in that sense because you go with the flow, what you see. إِنِّي وَجَدْتُ امْرَأَةً تَمْلِكُهُمْ يعني لغة غريبة إنه استهجان the bird is surprised وأوتيت من كل شيء ولها عرش عظيم In that particular verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we ponder across the verse we find out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws out the role of a female what she's supposed to do and differentiates between the female and the male without us even paying attention unless we ponder upon the verse as Allah in the Quran says أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا In order for them to come across to understand what Allah is saying they have to ponder amongst the Quran they have to ponder across the verses to understand what's being said in the Western world back in the 1580s they came what they called التجمع الديني الفرنسي تجمع الدين الفرنسي the French Institute of Theology they gathered up and they came up with a conclusion that a female was born or Allah created a female to be subservient to the male for her to serve the male after further delegations later on in the 1790s the woman was being sold on the streets of London for penniless dollars and The last but not least, the European philosophers came up with a conclusion. They were brainstorming and they came up with a conclusion and they were asking themselves, is the woman, هل المرأة روح أم غريزة? Is the woman a soul or is she
desire?
Is she a soul or is she, والعياذ بالله, is she like an animal, a desire that follows desire? They were pondering across that. طبعا نحن because we're not in the public eye and we don't read up and we don't know this information that this is what they're delegating. So they're discussing, is she this or is she that? Why? Because of all the troubles that the woman creates in the Western society. هل هي روح? Is she a soul? أم غريزة? Does she have a mind? Does she think on her own? Must we think for her? Must we control her? Must we tell her what to do? Yet, at the same token, the finger is being pointed at us that a woman in Islam is, her rights are taken away. مثل ما بيقولوا انه سرق الكذب الكذب وصدق. يعني they made up the lies and then they believed it themselves and they knew that they made up these lies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, time out. How does Islam look at this? أول شيء before we go any further, we have something in Islam that here in the Quranic verse where the bird was surprised and said, إِنِّي وَجَدْتُ امْرَأَةً تَمْلِكُهُمْ He made a few points, but the biggest point that he started with, that I seen a female owning. عِنَّ in Islam, روح, the European scent made its way across